Hey guys, Dr. Adil here. Today we're going to be doing a procedure for a patient who's been suffering with severe lower back pain for the last few months. And as many of you know, back pain is very common and it affects millions of people. It's actually the most common cause of disability worldwide. A lot of people don't realize muscle and joint issues are the number one reason why people miss work and the number one reason for disability. A lot more people die, you know, from cancer and heart disease, but quality of life and economic burden from back pain and from musculoskeletal disorders is much, much higher. So that's why it's so important for us to not only try to, you know, prevent it, but, you know, come up with effective treatments. So in today's case, we have a patient who essentially has degenerative disc disease and chronic lower back pain. And he also has something called modic changes in his spine. So those modic changes are inflammation in the bone. We call it bone edema, but essentially you can think of it as chronic inflammation in the bone. So he has disc issue, which is wear and tear of the disc. And the disc is like a cushion or shock absorber you can think about in between the bones. And so if that wears out and becomes thinner than normal, you can get chronic inflammation and then you can also get pain. A part of that is, you know, part of normal aging for a lot of people, but for whatever reason, in other people, it does cause a lot of pain. And some people genetically are just predisposed to having more degenerative disc disease. And of course, there's always a component of, you know, injuries and whatnot that can exacerbate the condition. But in this case, there wasn't anything particular that he did that caused it. It was just more of a gradual condition that came on. And that's like a lot of my patients, is just degenerative, is not really traumatic. And so in order to treat him today, we're going to be treating both issues, which is degenerative disc and then also the bone inflammation. So the way we're going to be doing that is we're going to be injecting platelet-rich plasma into the disc directly. And as most of you probably know, platelet-rich plasma is where we take the blood and we concentrate the platelets. And those platelets have an anti-inflammatory effect that help to reduce inflammation and pain. They also have a little bit of regenerative effects, which may help, you know, increase the disc height as well. But the main effect is really anti-inflammatory and to help reduce his pain. And then we're also going to be doing what's called basivertebral nerve ablation, which is a little bit more invasive procedure where we go into the bone directly and sort of use heat to help reduce the inflammation and, you know, sort of burn the nerves around the area that are causing the pain. But it's to cause a reaction to help actually get rid of the bone inflammation. So it's actually trying to heal as opposed to just masking the pain. And these are both minimally invasive procedures, as you'll see. We also like to use platelet poor plasma to inject into the muscles around the area. The reason being for prevention and strengthening. And a lot of times there's actually chronic muscle tears in the multifidus and paraspinal muscles in the lower back that don't get diagnosed on MRI. So we also often pick that up on our high resolution ultrasound and inject there. So it's a really more comprehensive approach that way. And so you'll kind of see the whole process today and see, and then we'll keep you guys posted on the update as hopefully he gets better over the next few months.
The least picky patient you'll ever have.
Oh, that's good. And you own a bakery, you said?
Yes.
What kind of bakery?
Italian bakery.
Italian bakery? Dollar what other kind of bakery is there?
Yeah, good point.
Do you make cannolis?
Cannolis, everything. Cannolis. I brought a whole bunch of stuff for the staff.
That's nice of you.
That's so nice of you.
If I need you like cannoli, I would have brought you cannolis.
Next time.
Deal.
So Ed, as I was talking earlier to the camera, we were talking about back pain and how it's probably the most burden on the economy in terms of disease burden and economic cost, because it affects millions of people. So can you tell people a little bit about how it's been affecting you and what happened and all that?
You know what? I'm a baker. I work long days. And as back pain creeps up on you, it alters your life, your mood, the things you want to do, the things you can do, the things you can't do. I love personally to work out, and that's a great stress relief for me. With back pain, I'm unable to do it. Like, it's just it drives this negative doubt in your head. It's you're angry that the pain is unreal. So for anyone dealing with back pain, if you don't deal with it, it just only get worse. Just really affects your everyday life.
The quality of life
goes right downhill. The things you enjoy to do, you don't enjoy doing them anymore.
Yeah, exactly. So was there anything that triggered it or anything that you think caused it? Or
you know, it could be the working out. It could be working 18 hours a day.
Yeah.
It could be one of many things. But at the end of the day, We're here to live.
Yeah, exactly.
So whether it's working out or working, your body shouldn't be compromised.
Yeah, exactly.
So that's why I'm here today.
Yeah, and I think a lot of doctors will just tell people to stop working out or do that.
Yeah, that's the number one thing I heard is, you know, stop working out, you know, maybe try not to work so much. At the end of the day, you work to pay your bills and you work out to kill your stress. Take away that, then what's the point of living?
Yeah,
right? Exactly. So when you find the right people that could help get rid of the pain, it's the way to go.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what we're going to try to do for you today. And, you know, we'll keep progress, obviously, and see how you do. But we're going to get you out of pain and back to doing what you want. The problem is when you can't work out, too, and you become weaker, and then when you become weaker, you get more pain.
So
it becomes like
pain.
A vicious cycle. Yeah,
exactly.
So the whole point of the procedure is to help break that cycle as well. So that's what we do. Part of the reason is to get you strong again too, and get you moving.
I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited to get rid of this pain. So
yeah,
let's do it.
Yeah, all right, perfect. All right. Okay, guys. So we took his blood. We used our centrifuge to spin it, and now we've concentrated the platelets to what we want. Basically, it increases the platelet concentration. There's different ways to make PRP. The one we're using today with this kit specifically has more white blood cells in there, and that's actually been shown to be more effective for degenerative disc disease. So it's called leukocyte rich PRP. And so the color of it is a little bit more, you know, well, there's, this is this. So you can see here, there's different layers with the buffy coat. And then this top layer is what's called PPP, platelet poor plasma. And then the PRP is kind of in here. So we're gonna isolate that. And there's different types of PRP, so it's important to know that it's not like a one-size-fits-all, and different types depending on what we're trying to target. So today we're going to be using this one specifically because there's been more research on that for degenerative disc disease.
So we're going to try to inject the needle directly into the disc. So we're going to go in between the bones. You can see on the x-ray there. You'll see him mark the spot. So this is the platelet poor plasma. So platelet poor plasma has been shown to be good for muscles because it's less likely to form scar tissue as well. And this is the platelet rich plasma. And this one is what we call leukocyte rich, meaning it has white blood cells, which has been shown to be effective for degenerative disc disease. Now we're going to guide the needle directly into that space where you see where the tip of the needle is. So now,
so now you should feel almost like a brush, okay? Until the needle gets to the
tip.
When the needle gets to the tip, you won't feel warm and fresh. You'll feel like kind of a little bit resembling the thing that you usually have on a day-to-day. On one spot.
You're using the x-ray the whole time so you can know exactly where you're going. Yeah, and this is called multi-planar view, meaning this will help us gauge the depth, how much further he needs to advance the needle. You can see on the screen the needle's almost into the disc, into the middle. Middle of the disc, sorry. Middle.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the fact that you
Yeah.
I'm not quite sure that I can even get to this.
You got it, right away. So it's exactly where he wants, which is in the middle of the disc, and that's been verified in two views. What's called AP view or lateral. So once you have verification in both views, then you can inject contrast to verify the position of the needle, and then we'll inject the plasma.
In case there will be calcium gluconate, you need to say glue.
Yes. So the calcium gluconate, what he's doing now, is just to activate the plasma and helps it kind of stay where it's supposed to. So now I'm going to inject around the muscles and in the back, because a lot of times there can be chronic muscle tears and that can be causing some of the pain as well. But it won't be as uncomfortable as what you just experienced. It'll be relatively minor.
Let me give you some film.
Yeah. Okay, now I'm missing something.
Thanks.
No, you can do it. You can come as close as you like for this, because it's not as sterile for this part. Basically, you just use the ultrasound at the same level where we injected the disc. We just go into the find the multifidus muscle. There's going to be a needle here, okay? 1, 2, 3. You can see the needle on the screen there. You can see it moving. You see there. So it's in the muscle there. We're just going to inject it around there. Same thing for the other side on the same level. Okay, another needle. 1, 2, 3.
Okay, guys, so what you just saw in the video was us injecting platelet-rich plasma directly into the disc. So as you saw, we did a step-by-step. We used a needle and we guided it directly into the disc. This is very important because a lot of people still do their injections without image guidance. And not only is it inaccurate, it can actually be detrimental or harmful. So just make sure if you're getting injection, it is guided by some sort of imaging, whether that's x-ray or ultrasound. And then the other thing that we did was we used platelet poor plasma to inject into the muscles, and we use the ultrasound guidance for that. And so now we're going to do a follow-up, you know, in 4 to 8 weeks, and we'll see how he's doing. And then based off that, we'll decide if we need to do anything more. We'll keep you guys posted on his results, but we expect him to do quite well as he is younger, and people who are younger usually do respond pretty well to the PRP treatments and to the disc. That's it for the video today, guys. So if you know anyone with back pain, feel free to share this video and hopefully they'll find it helpful.